a big object, a big rock is there. What kind of motion that can perform? It can simply move forward like that. It can simply move like that. Or it can spin. It can just spin. Like for example, fan is spinning. Okay? Or it can spin as well as move forward. Getting it? So spinning and moving forward, like for example, let's say a spinner is balling. Ball is spinning and moving forward. That is your rigid body motion. Okay? So when that happens, then you will understand what I am saying here. That you need to observe everything relative to a point on the rigid body first. In a rigid body, what will happen is that distance of every point from every other point is fixed. Yes or no? For example, if I take a big object like this, let's take any two points on the object, any two points. Will the distance between these two points be changing if the object is not deforming? Distance will not change, right? That is why it is a rigid body. Okay? If distance between these two points is fixed, then how these two points can move related to each other? They can move only in a circle. Okay? So when a rigid body is moving, spinning and moving forward, it is nothing but collection of circular motions happening. Many, many circular motions are happening together. Okay? Let's say it is just spinning. It is spinning. Like for example, fan. Fan is not a point object. Every point on the fan is moving with different speed. We have discussed that. Okay? So, fan is an example of a big object spinning. All the points on the fan, they are moving in a circle related to center. Concentric circles. Alright? So, in this chapter, what we are going to do is that we are going to only observe one point moving in a circle. But when we go to the rigid body motion chapter, there we will take the entire object and then we will study all the circular motions together. All the points in there, suppose n particles are there, all the n particles starts to move in a circular motion. How to write kinetic energy of that? How to write potential energy of that? That we will discuss later on. Right now we are taking a very simple scenario. A point is moving in a circle. Okay? And mostly the center is at rest. Why I have told you everything else? Because you should be aware that that is not the only thing that exists. Anyways, let's take the simplistic scenario now. Draw a circle. This is a circle in which a particle is moving in a circular path. Let's say radius is R. Radius is R and the speed of the object is u. Okay? Please write down one thing, that in any kind of motion, direction of velocity is always tangent to the path. Need not be circular motion, whatever it is. Direction of velocity at any moment is always tangent to the path. Tangential to the path. Direction of velocity is tangential to the path. Okay? Fine. So when I'm learning circular motion, I'll be studying circular motion in two different ways. Circular motion can be uniform circular motion or non-uniform circular motion. Please write down. It can be uniform as well as non-uniform. Can anybody describe what is uniform circular motion? Constant speed. Okay, please write down an object moving with a constant speed in a circle is a uniform circular motion. An object moving with a constant speed in a circle is a an example of uniform circular motion. Okay. Now I am giving you here 4 points. A, B, C and D. Can you represent the velocity? Suppose the object is moving like this. Show the velocity. 4 points. How the velocity will be? It will be like this here. At point C it will be like this, point A it will be like that, point B it will be like this. Yes or no? Is the velocity changing or constant? Velocity is changing, but magnitude of velocity is constant. So will there be an acceleration? Velocity is changing with time or not?
Yes.
Velocity is changing with time. So acceleration is present. Acceleration is there. Okay, write down. Since velocity is changing with time, since velocity is changing with time, acceleration must be present. Acceleration must be present. Now, if acceleration is there, what should be there? Who creates acceleration? What do you need to create acceleration?
Force.
Force is required to create acceleration, right? So there must be a force required. A force is required to create a circular motion. A presence of force must be there to create a circular motion. If that force is not there, you cannot expect a circular motion. Understood? Okay, now let us try to derive what is that acceleration, how much it is, and what is the direction of acceleration. Clear? Alright? So this is one of those examples where you will find out what is the acceleration, then you will find out what is the force that is required. Usually what we do, we find out force and then equate it to mass and acceleration to get the acceleration. But here, why we are finding acceleration first? Because it is given that it is moving in a circle. I need to find out how much force is required to move in a circle. So what I'll do, I'll first find out what is the acceleration required to move in a circle. Alright, so let us try to derive the acceleration, how much it is. By the way, anybody knows the magnitude of acceleration? Have you heard of centripetal acceleration? Ajay, let me discuss one more thing here. Have you ever experienced that when a vehicle is taking a sharp turn and you are inside the vehicle, you tend to be moving outside? Why? Understood. Inertia. But the vehicle is moving a circle. Vehicle is moving a circle. But you are not, I mean you are resisting to move in a circle. Why? Because there is no force present for you so that you can move in a circle. So what do? You slide to the door and then normal reaction from the door creates the provision for that required force so that you move in a circle. Okay, when the earth is rotating around the sun, where is the force? Sir, earth is moving in a circular motion, where is the force? Gravitational force. Gravitational force is there, right? When you tie a stone and you rotate in a circle. Where is the force? Tension force. A string applies that force. So every time there is a circular motion, there must be a force. And what are examples that we have taken? The motion of earth and the string, that force is towards the center. Okay? Now, tell me one thing. If the force is not towards the center, but if force is tangential, suppose tangential force is required to make sure that it is uniform circular motion. Understand what I'm saying? Then will the magnitude of velocity remain constant? If I'm saying that if I apply force, let's say this particle is moving in a circle. If I apply force in this direction, will the magnitude of this velocity change or not?
Yes.
Magnitude of velocity will change. Are you getting it? Magnitude changes. But I don't want to change the magnitude, I just want to change the direction. Otherwise it is no longer uniform circular motion. Yes or no? So there should not be any component of force in the direction of velocity. Please write down. In a uniform circular motion, there should not be any component of force in the direction of velocity. In a uniform circular motion, there should not be any component of force in the direction of velocity. Otherwise, what will happen? The magnitude of velocity will change. Okay? Right? So what do you think is the option?
Perpendicular.
If force is perpendicular to velocity, then that force has no component in direction of velocity. Are you getting it? So you have two directions perpendicular to velocity. Either like this or like that. Which one? This one or that one? One, two. How will you say one? Okay, two. Okay, right, go ahead. Both. Okay, see. If there is a confusion, you see which direction the velocity is going. You can see that velocity has turned that way. So the force should be in that direction. Alright? So please write down that the force required by the object to move in a circle. Force required by the object to move in a circle will be towards the center. Will be towards the center. I am talking about uniform circular motion only. Okay? The force required will be towards the center. So if you have to find out in a circular motion where is the center, find out the direction of force, extended line, somewhere on the line, center will lie. Okay? So the force always is perpendicular to velocity and towards the center. Now let's see the direction of forces. The force here will be like this. Here it will be like that, like this. So is the direction of force constant?
No.
Even the direction of force is continuously changing. If the velocity direction changes, immediately the direction of force adjusts itself to make sure the direction of force is again towards the center. So that the force and velocity are always perpendicular. Okay? That is what is happening when anything moves in a circle. When Earth is moving in a circular motion around this Sun, right now, let's say Earth is here, this is Sun, the force is like that. When Earth goes there, the force is like that. So even direction of force is getting adjusted. Okay? Fine, so we have found out the direction of force now. Okay? Now let us try to find out the magnitude of that force. Okay, in order to find the magnitude of force, first we will find out magnitude of the acceleration, and then just multiply with mass, you will get the